Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very honored and pleased to be here today to co-open this IMI Stakeholder Forum 2019. I'm really impressed by the big number of stakeholders, researchers, business representatives who are present here. And to quote Pierre, it looks like as if IMI, ça marche. That was his comment. So thank you very much again for your presence. It's an opportunity for me to thank you for your commitment to research, your commitment to health research in particular, but also your commitment to achieve progress in terms of research and innovation by doing these things, this research and innovation together, across the borders and across the sectors involving both business and research. And I think this is really one of the features of European research landscape for which we are praised. Just recently, I read an article in Nature which really praised this particular environment in Europe as to how we do research and how we govern research. So thank you very much again for your commitment. Now, as regards the topic, understanding the human brain, the most complex organ in our body, remains one of humanity's greatest challenges. Alzheimer's disease, epilepsy, multiple sclerosis, mental health conditions, they put a huge burden on our society. Depression alone affects 7% of the European Union population, while mental and behavioral diseases such as dementia are now the seventh leading cause of death in the European Union. This shows that brain and mental diseases continue to be an important public health need. Recent advances in digital health technologies, including the use of machine learning and artificial intelligence to analyze big data, can be without any doubt game changers in the pursuit of a better understanding of the brain and brain disorders. Finding solutions for brain disorders is an ambitious task, and developing innovative technologies for studying brain health and disease should be a common goal. On the other hand, the digital revolution is entering our lives, and we hope that one day it will enable patients to access their healthcare information anywhere and anytime and to benefit from personalized prevention and treatment. Cross-sectorial cooperation by health-related industry is important for progressing in our understanding of the brain health and disease. I welcome the fact that IMI is engaged in this difficult but important area. I'm also pleased to see the efforts to involve various, now also digital sectors, in these discussions. This is particularly important because, as you all know, we are advancing with the preparation of Horizon Europe, the next framework program for research and innovation. Like under Horizon 2020, the current program foresees a part of Horizon Europe for a health cluster that will be implemented through public-private partnerships. You also have seen that we are proposing a specific mission relating to cancer. We will do our usual calls. But one instrument to implement Horizon Europe will be public-private partnerships. This is what the member states, the Council, and the European Parliament have already agreed that we should pursue to examine whether public-private partnership in the health area should be implemented. Now, as a consequence, a number of such partnerships are under discussions with various architectures according to the three types foreseen. You might have followed that in preparing Horizon Europe, there was a big discussion as to whether we should simplify the landscape for research and innovation, and in particular with regard to partnerships. And I think we have now structured it along three possible architectures for partnerships. There are the co-programmed partnerships, the co-funded partnerships, and the institutionalized partnerships. The institutionalized partnerships is what you know now presently as the Innovative Medicine Joint Undertaking. One of the potential new partnerships could therefore be Innovative Health, bringing together the European Union and various health-related industry sectors, such as pharmaceuticals, biotech, diagnostics, medical devices, digital and imaging. With such a partnership, we would like to facilitate technology integration and to accelerate development and the uptake of health innovations in areas of unmet public needs. However, before deciding on the direction of Horizon Europe and of such a partnership, we would like to hear your views. For that reason, the European Commission has already launched what we call an impact assessment, also relating to the partnerships, to find out which kind of governance system in terms of partnership most fits the purpose of innovative medicine. But we have also launched, or we will very soon launch, a broader open public consultation on the strategic planning progress for Horizon Europe in order to fine-tune the topics we intend to address through our health cluster in Horizon Europe. Therefore, I would like to invite you to provide your feedback once this initiative will be launched. I think it's in 1, 2, 3 weeks that we will launch this consultation on the strategic planning, to provide your feedback via the Commission's so now I cannot read it anymore. Commission's, it's called Have Your Say internet portal. In addition, we will organize the European Research and Innovation Days in Brussels from 24th to 26th of September. This event will feature a high-level policy conference, an innovative Europe hub, and the Science is Wonderful exhibition. This will be the place to discuss and shape the future research and innovation landscape. And again, I would like warmly to invite you to register also for this event. However, before we go into any potential new partnership, IMI2 is still running, and the last call of 2020 could form a bridge to the activities of the new partnerships. From that perspective, I very much welcome today's discussion. Again, I'm very pleased to co-open this stakeholder forum 2019, and I really wish you a very fruitful meeting. Thank you very much. Thank you.